lifetime of accomplishments of which the dirt knows none. Only in death can one truly return. Return the carrots, the apples and potatoes, the chickens, the cows, the fish and tomatoes. In one glorious soup, let the deed be done and bury me deep so that I can be one. And all around my muscle, all around my bone, don't incinerate me or seal me from the dirt that bound me, the bed that rich from the rain falls upon and the fruit comes from. For the dirt is a blanket, no fiery tomb, no punishment reward or pearly white room. And you will say that in death we will pay the dead. They can't hear a word that you say. Your words are not kind, sober or giving. They only put fear in the hearts of the living. So put away your tongue, roll up your sleeve, pick up that shovel and bury me deep. Put away your tongue and roll up your sleeve, pick up that shovel and bury me. All around me, will this feeling cling? I can hear you singing in the corners of my brain. Every doubt the boundary, every sound of crying. everything is quiet, but the song that keeps me sane. Echoing my voice softly, I can feel your strength reinforcing mine. If you fear I lose my spirit, like some drunken wasted wine, don't you even think about it.
To me is like sending words to a black hole. You say writing to me is like sending words to a black hole, a deep hole to be swallowed, never heard from again. A deep hole to be swallowed, never heard from again. But that's just not true. No, that's just not true. I hang on every word. I hang on every word. And I fold them and I hold them in my pocket and in my head. And I fold them and I hold them in my pocket and in my head. She says, you never write back. How come you never write back? I mean to really, I just haven't had the chance yet. I just haven't had the chance yet. What do all these people expect from me? Can
Can't they tell? Can't they see? I've been so busy. Oh, maybe one day we'll be able to communicate telepathically. Maybe one day telepathically. Imagine if there were a ring two people could wear, and they could know each other's thoughts and their feelings without the tangled web of words. And we would never have to watch our words again. No, we would never have to watch our feelings again. You say, telling me your feelings is like handing eggs to a passing cyclist. But look, they're all here. I haven't dropped one yet. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. She says, you're being selfish. You know, you avoid communication. No, I think again. Well, maybe.